Bonjour friends, Dr. Chris here from Smile Modern. So for today's Burst TV, we have a special topic on branding. So I'm going to be going over branding about how to apply it to you as an individual, a dental professional, also for your private practice or office. And today we actually have a special guest. So today, my office manager, my other half, Serena, will be joining us. Yay!
Hello!
And she's actually a very big part of the brains behind our branding and some other social media topics we're going over later.
Cool. So I'm going to kick this off by telling you about what is brand and how do you establish a brand. So basically, a brand is essentially, for example, for us, our name, Smile Modern. That is the brand. But how do we describe what is Smile Modern? For us, we use personable, homey, and chic, meaning that when patients come to us, it's like coming to a friend's house. It's very personable. You know, they don't get scared. It's actually, they have fun when they come and they actually want to come. Second is going back to like going to a friend's house, homey. We want to create that comfortable vibe for them, and chic because, you know, we're a little bougie.
So the big takeaway is the three words to describe your brand, and that's what those three words are to us. So you want to think about how that applies to you. Okay, so the next part is your niche. So this is different than the three words to describe your brand. This is a bit more specific. So for me, I have my personal Instagram account, Happiest Dentist, and the niche for that is Disney. So there's Disney Dentistry and Style for that account, and I apply that to my office and Smile Modern. So you want to find what is something specific to you and your audience that you can connect with and engage with. And now I'm going to let Serena tell you about what to do with these two pieces.
So you have brand and niche. That should equal an experience. How do you take experience and put it into a marketing aspect, right? First of all, it's going to be, how are you going to expose yourself, right? As for us with our dental office, we tried a lot of different types of marketing outlets. We did shopping carts, you know, on the ads. We did Yelp ads. We also went to local businesses, door to door, drop off, you know, goodies that I created, which have, for example, a flyer of our special, a bio of him, and then, you know, a free gift that for patients when they come out with a new patient exam. And in there have like a toothbrush or floss or toothpaste, for example. And we also did events with local schools. He would go in and educate them about, you know, healthy oral hygiene care. We also participated in YMCA, AYSO for city events. And lastly, social media. And what we notice is social media actually helped us out a lot. And Dr. Chris will touch more based on that.
So for us, from the different marketing tools, we actually had our greatest conversion from social media. So we were wondering, like, why is social media doing better? It's also something that we didn't have to pay for. We were mm-hmm. doing our own social media. It saves a lot for your practice. So we self-reflected about why is our social media so effective, or how can we make it more effective? So the two major platforms kind of right now are Facebook and Instagram. Of course, this will vary based on your location. For us, Instagram is more marketable, more effective in our area. We're in Southern California. In other areas, Facebook might be better. Our Instagram is linked to our Facebook, so the content does go there, but we get a better response on Instagram. In addition to that, recently TikTok has been taking off. That's kind of like a new world and culture for us that we are trying to tackle, but we haven't seen a lot of conversion from that. So we're kind of still learning that, but we're trying to integrate that as well.
So, going back to what we were saying about experience and marketing, how do you translate experience through a screen, right? Because people these days are just scrolling, and if something catches their attention, they'll watch it. That, for them to stop to watch what you posted, that's value. So what exactly is value, and how do you figure out what your value should be? Because the last thing you want to do is just to post something to post. We'll let you know right now, that's not going to be effective. just like those shopping cart ads were not affected and they caused a lot of money. But I'll let you explain value.
Okay, so value is going to be also very key. This is what your audience is taking away from what you're posting. So again, like Serena was saying, you don't want to just post to post. We need to kind of curate and strategize and think about what we're going to be putting into this post. So for us, we kind of have three major areas that really bring value from us to our patients and to our audience. The first one is going to be education. So for our educational posts, we do a lot of like dental tips, reviews of dental products, also facts, things that are common questions or information that we think that the patient would benefit from or might not know about that might kind of be just more common sense to the dentist or the dental professional.
Now, the second one will be entertainment. So as Dr. Chris mentioned, you know, we focus on education, right? But how can you make education entertaining? Because I'm guilty of one, I don't always read the caption, but if it's in a video, then I think, oh, I'm learning something and I'm having fun with it. For example, we did a charcoal toothpaste post to let patients know, hey, charcoal is actually not very good. It's pretty abrasive. And it was a really fun, like, you know, 60 seconds TikTok video. But that went really well for us. A lot of people were sharing it, commenting on it, saving it. So going back to entertainment, you can make something educational fun, right? You don't have to make it super serious and super boring, but how do you make it, you know, entertaining? That's where research comes in. I actually spend a lot of time, honestly, on TikTok, on Instagram, looking at other people's pages and seeing what they're putting out there. You know, why am I drawn to this more than that? And I try to apply that into our, when we're creating our content, but how do we make it our own and be authentic with it? And lastly is looking at, you know, your insights. We definitely do that at least, you know, every other week just to kind of see what posted well, what were people really liking, and knowing that, oh, if patients or followers, for example, like this type of style, then maybe we should do more of this, right? So yeah, and then lastly.
So one more thing I want to add for that section is when you're curating or creating your content, just always think about your brand and the niche. Sort of like when you're writing an essay and you're going back to like your topic sentence, what is your theme? Like always incorporate that back. Mm-hmm. That's going to kind of tie it together and give you focus and direction. And our last area of value is office culture. So for office culture, what does that really mean? So for us, it's the patient experience. Like how do we engage with our patients? What are they experiencing when they come? What are they taking away? How do they feel? Also, we like team building. So we like to do a lot of activities with our staff outside of work, whether it's like a boba run, a dinner at Korean barbecue. Mm-hmm. We've also gone to like a Broadway show, also Disney California Adventure. So these types of things also create the team, make it stronger, and then you're also showing that to your patients because if you have a strong team, then they also feel confident that mm-hmm. they're receiving care from you. And so lastly, the main thing to take away from all of this is really just be genuine, be yourself. Like that's going to shine through the most. Don't try to copy others. And you can get inspiration, but it actually takes more work copying other people's ideas. So if you can just find what is the definition of you, your practice, your brand, and bring that to the content that you create, then it will go a long way. Because we've seen that and we get a lot of response to it. We get a lot of DMs. Even I've gotten approached by my patients at Disneyland just mm-hmm. walking down Main Street. So it really connects with a lot of people. So just keep that in mind. And any other last words?
I would definitely say have fun. Don't stress out. Don't overthink it, you know, because there's some times where we're like, oh, do we think this will do well? Well, let's try. And mm-hmm. it does so well that we get people honestly DMing us going, hey, how can I make an appointment with you? And once again, this is free, you know, so you save a lot of money. It's just going to take your time, but you're going to enjoy seeing the results. So good luck.
And making your brand more approachable actually decreases a lot of the anxiety that many people feel. I mean, we all know that dentistry is not the favorite stop for everyone. Some other tips is oftentimes Serena will create like a social media schedule. Mm-hmm. It really helps you to organize your thoughts and also goals for your content creation. And also, if you have an idea, write it down. Sometimes you forget. It's a lot of inspiration. Screenshot, screen record, anything that will kind of just re-spark that idea later. And we're just going to continue making content for you guys. Hope you enjoy it. If you have any questions, you can also contact us and DM. And other than that, happy content creating.
Bye. Bye.